Earlier in the show, we aired a comment about the growing incidence of teens raiding their parents' medicine cabinets or purses in an effort to get their hands on anything that they can take themselves for a high or even sell to their peers. With us this afternoon to preview what's called a Lock It Up campaign, there's an event this Thursday night. We have Ann Eber here. She's a pharmacist at Meritor. Ann, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
We appreciate it. Lock It Up. Talk to us just in general about what this campaign is and why it's important.
Well, the campaign is really set up to educate people, whether it's teenagers, their parents, their grandparents, and others, that, you know, having medicines around the house is not a safe thing. Kids are very savvy, kids, teenagers, and they will find things to do with medicines that are probably not safe.
Which we've been having this conversation now for years. This is nothing new. Are we just slow to really kind of acknowledge that some of what we're taking may also be something that our kids would even look at? We were talking about this during the break. You have a 13-year-old.
I have a 13-year-old daughter, and to be honest with you, until I started really looking into this, it was not something that I thought about either. Assuming my daughter wouldn't get into these things. But I think there's a lot of peer pressure out there, too, that sometimes that, you know, things that you don't think they would do, they might consider more if their friends are doing it, for example.
Exactly. A lot of parents probably have the same thoughts about their kids. That's mm-hmm. not something that they would do or look at or take. But I mean, really being aware, you're a pharmacist, of what prescriptions we have, what they do to you, mm-hmm. and how much of what that prescription is in our little bottle. How important is that?
It's very important, and it's good for parents or grandparents, if they happen to be the ones with the medicines, monitoring what's in those prescription bottles.
Okay,
I have them on the shelf, and I don't know how many were left the last time I finished taking them.
And same goes for alcohol in the house.
And over-the-counter medication.
When's the last time you looked at a bottle that's been up on the shelf for years?
Right.
You know, perhaps you have some very specific prescription drugs that you wanted to point out are important that get locked up in some capacity. OxyContin, oxycodone, Vicodin, hydrocodone, and Percocet. Why those?
Those are all narcotics, and as you pointed out earlier, the number of kids that are getting into these, taking them, or selling them to their friends, they're very deadly, and we know that that has happened recently around here.
Too many often, what,
slow your heart rate, slow your respiratory rate, and kill you.
Stimulants, Adderall and Ritalin, those two are important to point out why.
Well, mostly because those are the type of medications that are similar to, like, speed. They increase your heart rate, and that's where most people get into trouble with that as well.
A couple of over-the-counter medications, cold medications. You have pseudoephedrine and another one that I'm not even going to try and pronounce.
Dextromethorphan.
Thank you.
It's a common ingredient in cough medicine. And this is one that I was totally unfamiliar, well, I shouldn't say totally, but unfamiliar with the extent to which some teenagers are getting into that.
Which is why when you go to, mm-hmm. you know, any drugstore or Target or wherever it is now, they've got those all behind the counter.
The pseudoephedrine they do. The dextromethorphan maybe not.
Steroids, laxatives, and acetaminophen. Why are those important to point out?
Well, it's just teenagers can get into those as well and cause problems. Laxatives are mostly related to eating disorder type things.
So look for those.
Steroids, yes.
Okay. The event is this Thursday night. Today, not tomorrow, is the organization putting it on. It's a town hall meeting, 6:30 p.m. this Thursday night. Parents, kids, community leaders, I believe the police department is going to be involved. There are just so many people coming together who really believe we need to be looking at locking up our medications, our alcohol, mm-hmm. and our guns. It's all going to be discussed that night. And thanks so much for being with us.